A right-hand side overhand basketball layup can be classified as a closed, discrete skill in an on-game situation that is highly organized with high complexity. Whole practice is recommended. However, due to its high complexity, some natural units within the skill will also be part practiced. The activity is classed as 1D according to Gentile's taxonomy. The movement has stationary regulatory conditions and no intertrial variability with an object. The 4-week program that has been developed is adapted from current research, fits in Posner's 3-stage model, Gentile's taxonomy, and guidance hypothesis. The aim of this 4-week program is for skill acquisition to increase accuracy, foster positive transfer into a game situation, retention, and motor learning. For the pre-testing, the player will watch a video of an expert modeling a layup. The player will video themselves performing 10 attempts at a right side layup and will record the accuracy. The performance outcome measure is accuracy. The performance production measure is video analyses. There are 3 main stages to the layup. The first stage is the 2-step footwork. After the fast dribble and approach towards the key, the player needs to take 2 big steps towards the basket to get underneath it. The first step with the ball in hand is with the right foot. The second step will be with the left foot just before pushing off. The second stage is to raise the right knee and elbow and keep the eyes on target. After the left foot is planted, the player pushes off and raises the right knee, in line with the right elbow. Whilst doing this, the player's eyes should be focused on the target, which is the top right-hand corner of the square on the backboard, also known as the sweet spot. The right arm raises towards the basket, the left arm should have dropped slightly but still be protecting the shot. The third stage is soft touch to finish. The ball needs to leave the player's hand softly so the speed will be reduced, and the ball will bounce into the ring, not off the backboard. The speed of the run-up should not transfer into the shot. It should be absorbed by the push-off. The training program. Ideally, a holistic training program would include small-sided games, defenders, and tactical programs. However, initially this program is focused on teaching the layup as a closed skill before progressing to a more open skill. Week 1. Week 1 of the training program involves a warm-up, 4 laps of dribbling, reach drill, sweet spot drill, watching a professional shot, 2 sets of layups from the key, and 1 set of 20 layups from different positions along a 3-point line. The reach drill involves standing with the ball in hand facing the basket. Using an overhand grip, raise the right knee and right elbow in alignment. This drill helps develop the basic muscle movements for a layup. Imagine there is a string connecting the elbow and the knee. The sweet spot drill works on the shooting phase of a layup. Stand under the hoop in position to shoot the ball. Raise the right knee and elbow and release the ball aiming for the sweet spot. The first basic layup drill will involve completing the whole layup starting on the key, at the third marker from the baseline. Bounce the ball once, then complete the 2 steps with the ball in hand and shoot. The second layup drill will involve starting from the 3-point line. This will give the player a chance to work on their run-up. Week 2. The program for the second week excludes the reach drill and watching the professional shot. Week 3. Week 3 gets rid of the sweet spot drill and introduces the half-court layups. Week 4. Week 4 introduces some defender drills and fatigue drills. The defender drill simply involves including a defender to try and block the shot. The fatigue drill involves performing a layup from half-court, retrieving the ball, then sprinting back to go again. This helps stimulate a game situation. Verbal cues that could be used in a session if a coach is present would include 1-2 for the two steps, up for the knee and elbow raise, and soft for the soft finish. Once the player has left the cognitive stage, they can use these cues for self-talk. Here is an example. 1-2-up-soft. Some motivation strategies that can be used include visual feedback improvement and an increase in the player's accuracy. Enhancing the memory can involve using mental practice, including imagery of skill and repetition of cue words. Relate back to past experience. Augmented feedback functions to facilitate achievement of the action goal of the skill and to motivate the learner to keep striving for a goal. In this learning environment, augmented feedback will include recording accuracy following each week's test, knowledge of results, and self-video analysis, knowledge of performance. Guidance hypothesis proposes that receiving augmented feedback less frequently during practice encourages the learner to engage in more beneficial learning strategies like active cognition and movement problem solving. The cognitive stage is the first stage of learning, and this will occur in the first week of the program. In the cognitive stage, there are normally large errors, the person will have difficulty identifying errors, there will be the use of tutorial and self-video feedback to detect and correct errors, and this stage has the highest level of feedback. Here are some common errors that can occur during the initial stages of learning the layup. Not slowing down the speed of the ball, missing the target, incorrect release from the hands, and not getting close enough to the hoop before making the shot. The associative stage involves the learned cues being associated with the movement, less errors and the player will be better at detecting errors, the performance becomes more consistent, there will be less dependence on the tutorial video, reduced feedback, and consistency will be reflected in weekly testing. The autonomous stage will occur in the fourth week of the program. Characteristics of the autonomous stage include the skill becoming automatic, the ability to perform another task at the same time, defenders, fatigue and anxiety added, and the least amount of feedback. Finally, some post-testing will occur. A retention test will be performed after a one-week washout period, then two transfer tests, one with layups from 10 different positions, and the second involving 10 layups with a defender.